Bellini comes chronologically last of our trio. Wagner, not one to lavish praise on another composer, was an unlikely admirer of Bellini. Unlikely because it would be hard to find two composers further apart in style and choice of subject. It was Bellini's ability to write music from the heart that earned him an accolade from Wagner, who said of Bellini's music that it comes from the heart and is intimately bound up with the text. Bellini was born in Catania, in Sicily, in 1801, and died near Paris in 1835, a few weeks short of his 34th birthday. We are told he was a handsome and popular boy, and something of a child prodigy, giving piano recitals at the age of 5. He was taught both by his father and, more intensively, by his grandfather. His non-musical education came in rather a sketchy fashion. The story goes that he never did learn to write good Italian, his letters seem to testify to this, but of his musical precocity there was never any doubt. When he had learned all that his grandfather could teach him, he was packed off to the Naples Conservatoire, where he was a star pupil. His graduation exercise was an opera entitled Adelson and Salvini, which still, surprisingly for a student exercise, gets the occasional revival at festivals. Unlike Donizetti, who had to wait until he had written over 30 operas before he had a hit with Anna Bolena, Bellini won almost instant success with his third opera, Il Pirata, The Pirate. The text was written by Felice Romani, who wrote the libretti for 7 of Bellini's 10 operas, a record of cooperation and mutual loyalty that was unusual in the turbulent history of composers and librettists. The year following the premiere of Il Pirata, 1828, it was given in Vienna, and Bellini was on the road to an international career. His next two operas were not successful. However, in 1830, he had a triumph with an adaptation of what we now think of as Romeo and Juliet, but which Bellini and his librettist called I Capuletti e i Montecchi, the Capulets and the Montagues. The libretto is, in fact, based not on Shakespeare, but on a much earlier version of the same story. So when Bellini and Romani include an aria in which Juliet bemoans her impending marriage to Tybalt, they are not, as is often stated, taking liberties with Shakespeare. The aria is called O Quante Volte, O How Many Times, and it serves as the perfect introduction to many of the hallmarks we shall detect in La Sonnambula. The rolling accompaniment, the pure, clear vocal tone, the cool elegance of the flute, and above all else, the long melodic line, which is beautiful in itself and calls for a very high level breath control from the singer. La Sonnambula followed in 1831, but we'll pass over it for the moment to report that in the same year, Bellini scored his most lasting hit with Norma. The less successful Beatrice di Tenda followed in 1833, and the final opera of his short but brilliant career was I Puritani, another of the many early 19th century operas to be based on the novels of Sir Walter Scott, this time Old Mortality. Incidentally, the original title of I Puritani, the Puritans, was I Puritani di Scozia, the Puritans of Scotland. But since the opera is set in Plymouth, we have to assume that geography was another subject skimped in Bellini's general education. I Puritani had its premiere in Paris in January 1835, and Bellini died in the town of Puteaux, near Paris, in September of the same year. His death was from amoebic dysentery, though he had been plagued with gastroenteritis for some 5 years. Here is a short extract from the best-known aria in I Puritani, Qui la voce. No wonder Verdi wrote of Bellini, long, long melodies such as no one has ever written before.